Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In the previous episode, we looked at how you can use clang-tidy and clazy from within Qt Creator. But sometimes it's useful to do that from the command line. I can think of two changes. First, you want to integrate with CI. Second, you want to do mass changes to your source code. If you've just learned about clang-tidy and clazy, and you try and run it on your own source code, I'll bet you have thousands, if not tens or hundreds of thousands of warnings on your source code, at least if you turned on all the warning levels. Now, you could go into your Qt Creator and just fix them one by one by one by one, and some of them you could even ask Qt Creator to fix automatically for you. And then you'll make one commit and you have found new ways of making enemies out there in the world, because that commit will have changes all over the place. And your coworker will go, really, is that a good idea? Maybe, no, not this one. Here's a much better idea. Once you have identified groups of changes that you'd actually like, make them one after the other. And especially for those that can be automatically done by clang-tidy or clazy, go to the command line, run that one fix on all of your changes, make a commit for that, make the next, make a commit for that, and maybe one of those automatic changes is not to your liking of those reviewing your code, and it's easy to just say, okay, let's forget about that one and carry on. Let's see how you do this from the command line. But before we get to the command line, let's get back into Qt Creator. As you can see from the errors here, or the warnings, I have a lot of checks turned on. And one of them says that I should be calling whatever. I can fix it, alt enter, and I say, well, let's just, that's the error that I want, clazy qstring allocations, and see what it did. Well, qstring literal added. Easy peasy. But if I had 100 or thousands of these, I'd rather go to the command line. So here we are at the command line. What I'll run is a command called clazy-standalone, of course. There's two, there's clazy and clazy-standalone, and the clazy, the one without standalone actually runs the front end too. And if you could just excuse me. I'm allergic to running clazy alone. So it's clazy standalone that I want to run. Let's see if I remember anything after that sneezy. Clazy standalone, and it's called column header adapter.cpp. And if you look at this error, you can see that it's complaining that it cannot even find Q abstract table model. What? Well, how would clazy standalone know about that you have this include directory, then this include, and so on. For that, we need something from Qt Creator. So go back into Qt Creator. You could do this with regular CMake without Qt Creator if you want to. But anyway, go into Qt Creator here, and you want it to generate or build you a compilation database. With the compilation database built, I can show you it's now in build wherever, and then it's called CMake. No, it's called compile command.json. What you see here is a number of parameters to your make, and this file is rather short, but in the end, I only have three files in this project. Had it been a real size project, it would have been a long one, but not for you to understand anyway. What you want to do is simply to run your clazy standalone, see if I can say that without sneezing, and then add the minus P option, minus P, and then column header length adapters.cpp. Now clazy standalone will go and read that compilation database and run the clang backend correctly together with your file to get this error. And yeah, that's a lot of errors in there, isn't it? But then again, these comes from Qt, and I don't work for the Qt company, so it's not for me, at least not today, to go and fix those. So what I'll simply do is that I'll add minus minus ignore dirs equal to, and then a regular expressions that matches this. So, well, blackie/qt, that should definitely do it for me. And now run it again, and I don't see anything. The reason why I don't see anything is not that I did something wrong. I actually thought that for a while, but the reason is that there are no errors in that file. What? Didn't we just see a lot of errors here? Well, none of those turned on. So with minus minus list minus checks, the clazy standalone will tell me which checks it actually did. And this is only those that are in the category level no, level zero. So if I add, let me just see here, checks equal to level zero, level one, level two. And then we can see now that I got more checks. And let's hope, if we just remove the list checks, that it actually will give me a warning now. Did I get invalid level one? Okay, so checks level zero, there we are. But anyway, I got the error already because this came from a different level. So far, so good. I ran a single check, but I would like to also get that fix executed because that's one of those that has a fixit. And the way that I do that is that I add yet another option, minus minus export minus fixes. And I give it a name here, fixes.yaml. And now I got a file called fixes.yaml in my build dir. Looks like this. Well, that was the, looks like this. Not for your eyes really, but if you really want, then you can see that, well, this file here at this offset, I will take seven characters and I'll replace that with this. I'll bet you seven characters, that's Q string. Yeah, that's seven characters that are now being replaced with Q string literal. Git diff. What? No changes? Well, for that, I need to run a tool called clang-apply-replacements, and I need to specify the directory where these changes were in, and it will look for all of the files with the extension YAML. And now, hopefully, here is my change. I am really sorry, not that I sneezed at you, but that I didn't tell you upfront that I have a script for you, so you didn't need to jot down all those parameters. Well, let me show you the scripts, and then that will hopefully make it up to you. The script is called clazy-fix-one-file, and it's not a super long script, as you can see. It basically just runs, and let me scroll down here, and you can see that it runs clazy-standalone, minus checks, that's the check that you specify via the command line parameter. You can see up here, you specify the file and the check. So minus checks, this one check, minus p, wherever your build dir is, and your build dir, that is assumed to be in your parent directory, build dash, that's what qtcreator does. Go and fix this script if you have a different standard for you. Then minus minus ignore dirs, the qt dir, so do not complain about qt dir, and that's the environment variable qt dir, at least. I have that set still to point to the root of my qt, so if you don't, then hard code your directories in here. Minus export fixes into this fixes.yaml, and then on the file specified. You run that, and then you will run clang apply replacements with this one and remove the fixes.yaml file at the end. If you want to know exactly what it does, then you can set an environment variable called verbose. If that's set, then it'll tell you a bit more. It looks like this when I run it. So I need to go over here again, and let me just see if I can find from my history. There we are. That's the command to see the warnings I had, and I ran this just so that I could cut and paste out this one here. So what I'll run is now is clazy-fix-one-file, and it needs first the file, so column header length adapter.cpp, and then it needs this name here without the clazy in front. It runs clazy again, but as you can see now, I got it changed. Of course, I should have shown you that I actually nuked the change beforehand, but there we are. Also, if I want, and that's where we're getting to, if I want to make this change on all of my sources, then instead of running clazy one file, I can run another one called clazy fix all files. And now I do not specify this one here. And what it'll do is that it'll run through all of my CPP files and my header, well, all my CPP files, and it will run the clazy fix one file on each of them. And now, I don't know, I likely didn't have this error in my main.cpp, so there are no new changes, but otherwise I would have it. So my workflow, I will go into Qt Creator, I will look at all the different errors that it spits out at me, and then I'll take them one after the other, run it like this. And I actually did that with a bunch of new errors just a few days ago, and some of them I didn't like, so I just ignored them. Some of them I ran and my coworker didn't like and pointed out why he didn't like them, so I could throw them out easily again. So that's the workflow. In clazy, there's only one little thing to be aware of that isn't super obvious, at least never is to me, namely which levels are enabled. So by default, level 0 is enabled, and as you saw with my command line, I could add more of them. But there's also the manual checks, and these cannot be enabled. So you can enable all of level 0, 1, and 2 by just, as I did in the code, minus minus checks equal to level 0, comma level 1, comma level 2, but you cannot write comma manual. Those you need to enable individual. Sergio, will you please fix that? Anyway, in the script that is on GitHub, where you can download the other script, you will also find two aliases, namely list checks or clazy list checks and clazy list manual checks. And the list manual checks will take you to the website where you can see the manual checks. Just a small worthwhile to know. Clazy was created at large by Sergio, I can't remember his last name, sorry Sergio, who works for KDAM. That's what I'm trying to say. Clang-tidy, on the other hand, has been created by the LLVM people, and that is a complete different group, so the command line parameters are slightly different for the two of them. They were parallels, they were developed somewhat a lot in parallel. So let's have a look at clang-tidy, how do you run that, and how do you run the fixes from the command line. So the command line is almost the same, but just slightly different than with clazy. So clang-tidy minus p specify the directory for the compile command file, the compilation database, minus checks, not minus minus checks, just minus checks, the full name, and while with clazy you would throw away clazy minus, here it's just a full name that you saw in there. And now minus fix is the option to add, and then it will actually run the fix on that one file, main.cpp, and now we are running it, and you can see that I actually got the fix already. Similar to clazy, I also created two scripts, clang-tidy fix one file, where I specify the file in question, and it's a script similar to this one again, file name and check, and there is clazy fix all files. Much simpler script this time, but same concept as before. Congratulations! You now know how to run clazy and clang-tidy both from within Qt Creator and how to do it from the command line. As I said initially, doing so from the command line only makes sense for CI and for mass changes, but I'll bet you that you will have a very good time fixing up your source code over the next few weeks with some of those changes. And some of them might feel really silly, but trust me, once you have them all up and running and your code is totally clean from warnings from clazy and clang-tidy, and you add this to your CI, then it feels good whenever a CI says, hey, did you know that you are actually in this for loop, you are risking detaching. That could slow down your code tremendously. So how about you add Q as const in there? I at least personally enjoy that very much. You've been watching yet another episode of Qt Widgets and More, and it's time for me to do the remember and all of that stuff. And it's also time for me to tell you that I would really love to hear back your thoughts on this series at large, but also things that you'd like me to possibly go into details with. Until next time, have a great time.